A songwriter, her former manager, Ethiopia, used to be my intern, so I'm really telling my age right now. But I had this wonderful career, right? Everything that you dream about, moved to New York City, had the job of executive vice president, the corner office, a nice whip, and I was making almost $500,000 a year. And in 2009, my mom got Alzheimer's, I had some health issues, and every day I would wake up and I couldn't understand what was going on. I was not happy anymore. And so I was starting to experience depression, but didn't really know what to call it. And then also my dad committed suicide when I was 7 months old. And I kind of buried that for a long time and just really put all my energy and time into work, but never properly dealt with my father's death. And we didn't go to counseling as a family. We all know how it is in the African-American community. We don't believe in therapists. We don't need that. We can just pray it away. And I am a big believer in Jesus, and I wake up thanking God every morning, but as it relates to mental health, it's just as important as your physical health. So 2 years ago, in 2015, I went on a downward spiral. As successful as I was, it was the first time that I really contemplated suicide. I was about to get out of here. And it was scary, and it was dark, and by no way am I happy about that situation, but I knew I needed to do something different. And I needed to help myself and to help other people. And so that's how Silence of Shame was born. We have our committee on the front row.